Hello, still on D-Light Channel, we are continuing our descent to land our conversation on life balance. And what have we been focusing on recently as we approach landing? We've been focusing on practical steps to achieving life balance. Last week, I touched on two that I called inside jobs. Number one is to reset your life equation. Okay, you need to change it, you need to redefine it, because you are able and you are responsible for that. And the second is the fact that you need to kick competition and kick perfection. They are the fundamental variables to everything else. Therefore, you need to please go watch them so that what we're going to talk about this week will make some sense to you. And therefore, I quickly move on to the third point that I am trying to share with you that I hope we help in achieving life balance for you as an individual. So, number three on the list is that you need to set your priorities right. So, when you reset your life equation, you change the equation, when you kick perfection, you kick competition, there will still be many things that you have to do. You are a parent. You are a father, you are a mother, you are a spouse, you are a brother, you are a sister, you are a son, you are an employee, you are an entrepreneur, you work in for certain NGOs, you are in a church, you are in a mosque, you've got sports, you've got hobbies, you've got old school, you are also a son, you are also a grandson, a granddaughter. There are different things that are calling for attention. If you will achieve life balance, everything cannot be on the same level. You must set your priorities right. There are certain things that can't wait. Your love life, raising your children, spending time with them, bonding with them, building them, investing in who they're going to be in the future. You can't delay that. Your academic pursuit, quickly getting your professional qualification out of the way, quickly getting your academic qualification out of the way, those things cannot wait. Your health, it won't scream, it won't shout, but if you don't look after your health will one day just stop and demand for all the abuse that you have treated it to, and you will have no choice than to pay back. So, in arriving at balance, you must understand that everything is not on the same level, and the levels and the priorities will shift. When you are just starting, and career should be high on your priorities, academics should be high on your priorities, professional qualifications should be high on your priorities, you can't at that same time give a lot of priority to recreation, to hobby, to sport, beyond just what you need to do to stay healthy. But as you then finish or significantly achieve those milestones, part of that time can then go into hobbies, socialization, social duties. Same for the family. When you get married, the kind of attention that your family requires from you for the first 10, 15 years of marriage is not the same after the 15th year. If your family goes through the normal curve, because at the beginning of your family, you are having children. There's a lot of care that has to be given to the infant, and then they become toddlers, and then they're trying to go to school, they got homework, they got this game, they got that sport. It is the foundational stage of their lives. That is where talents are discovered, that is where relationships are built, that is where a major part of the personality is formed, world outview, value system. You can't neglect them at that time. You can't postpone it. Go watch the very first video on this series. It's all about the fact that time can be accrued, can be postponed, can be delayed. You must get your priorities right. You must learn to do the right thing at the right time. Otherwise, you will have a big struggle getting balanced. That will be point number three. Point number four is that, having identified those priorities, you must be deliberate about them. They will not just magically appear because you have now said this phase, I'm going to place a lot of emphasis on my education and my health and my love life. And then when education drops, I'm going to pay attention to my family and my health and my social responsibilities. It does not just appear magically. You must be deliberate about it. You must schedule it. It means if you need to set an alarm, if you need to sign up to a gym, if you need to find partners with which you are going to exercise, if you need to sit down with your wife and agree commitment and time, sit down with your husband, whoever you need to do, whoever you sit with, do it. Do not just prioritize your schedule. You must schedule your priorities. And I'm not just playing with words. Don't just go through trying to prioritize your schedule. I have this to do. Okay. No. Find out what are your priorities and then schedule them. Let your employer know. Let your friends know. Let everybody around you know what is important to you and then run after it. Because it will not just happen. You must learn to say no. It's not every offer, it's not every demand, it's not every request that you say yes to. Because once you've identified your priorities and you've scheduled it, then things will come to want to jam it, things will come that will want to overtake them. You must learn to say no. You must learn to unplug. There's a saying in my language, I don't know how to literally translate it, that says that your work will live longer than you as a person. Because when you are long dead, your job still remain there. Somebody else will take over. You must learn how to unplug. Even if you sleep at work, you won't still finish. And remember that science has shown that even when you work so late at work, most of the time, the late work creates more problems for you the following day because focus is now low, concentration is low, the loss of diminishing returns. And even though you are seeming to be working very hard, by the time you come in the morning, you realize that many things you did the evening before were not done properly. Therefore, you must learn to be deliberate about it. There is a time when you must learn to just shut work out and be present. Don't practice presenteeism with your family. Be present, body, soul, mind. If it is work, if it is church, wherever you need to do it, be deliberate about it. Okay? And last but not the least on my list is that appreciate that life happens in stages. Life happens in stages. And let this awareness and the stage that you are in your journey guide you and influence you in scheduling your priorities. So like I said earlier, if you realize that, okay, this is the phase where I need to lock down, quickly put some time into my professional development, not to the neglect of everything else, but that takes priority. And then you realize that while that is going on, if you have a family, you cannot suspend them. If your health cannot be suspended, your social responsibilities that cannot be suspended, you are deliberate to know that the time will change. The children will not always be there. 10, 15 years, by the time your last child is about 5, 6, 7, all of a sudden they begin to acquire their own direction and you have a lot of time on your hand. Some things that you couldn't do at that time, you don't have time for them. But you can't delay their growing. So understand that life happens in stages and let that shape the way you set your priorities and the way you get deliberate about them. I'm sorry I took a bit of time this week, but it is critical to know that you can achieve life-life balance. The list I've given is not exhaustive, but if you do the inside job, which is to reset your life equation and to kick competition and perfectionism, then you come and do the outside job, which is what we've just listed this week, then you are giving yourself a good chance to achieve life-life balance. But whatever you take away from this week's video, what I'm trying to tell you is that life-life balance is achievable if you are committed to it and you apply some of these things that I've shared. I have one more to share on the entrepreneurial side. What can you do? You're an entrepreneur. How can you go about it? That will be on the menu next week. And I'm sure if you're an entrepreneur or you know somebody who is, let them know that is coming, and I hope to see them next week. Share this video, spread the word, show us some love. Let's know what you are feeling out there. Let's know if there's something we need to cover, and we will be glad to do. And until I come your way next week, T-Mac is still my name, D-Li is still the channel, and all we are trying to do is what? Make a little difference. I hope to see you next week. Bye.